Happy Guacamole Day, everybody. Food enthusiast and home chef Benjamin Gullett is with us right now. And we're talking guac. Hi, how are you?
I am so great. There's no better day to talk about guacamole than on Guacamole Day.
I could not agree more. I think I put guacamole on so many things that the average person would be shocked. You probably feel the same way I do about this, like, super.
Absolutely. Guacamole is so versatile. It's really more than a dip. You can really use it on just about anything. I like to dip vegetables in it, like zucchini or squash or celery and eat it like that. Or even, you know, if you make a good, nice flatbread, just get the marinara sauce and use a guacamole. It's delicious.
Oh, that does sound good. Well, I know you have your own secret recipe, so why don't I just let you take it on away?
Absolutely. I'll be honest with you, it's not too terribly secret, but it's foolproof and delicious. So
even better.
So you slice them in half, you give it a little twist, you're going to open it up just like that. And then you want to take that pit out. So I kind of just stab it with that knife, and I'm going to drop it into a bowl. Now what's great about these avocados today is you can get real fancy and slice them up, but on these, we're just going to kind of scoop all that good stuff out, drop them into our bowl here. Now for this recipe, we would usually use about 3 avocados, which I have. I'm going to kind of make this quick and viewable for the TV audience. So we've got all of our avocado in there, which is nice. And then we're going to add a little bit of salt, and we're going to add some lime juice. Now the lime juice is really great for keeping the avocado from browning, because it's going to do that very quickly on you, right? So you want it to be that nice, beautiful green color. So we drop those things in, and we're just going to smash up that avocado to sort of get it nice mixed up. You know, the avocado's been around since about 500 BC. So, you know, it's been used as a mash and a paste like these kinds of recipes. So guacamole is perfect.
It's funny because we substitute things, avocado for things, but it was the original paste, sort of, if you will.
Really, it really was. It kind of holds ingredients together. It's really versatile with mixing anything that you want in it. You know, the Aztecs were making it way back when, so it's lasted a long time. So we've added a little bit of garlic, a little bit of onion, and a little bit of chopped Roma tomato. And again, you're just going to get that nice little mix. You're just bringing all those ingredients together. And then the last thing I like to do is just a little bit of cilantro. It's always that flavor that you're not quite sure what it is, but it really takes the whole thing to a whole other level. Just a little pinch of that, mix it together, and you've got your guacamole. It's that simple.
I feel like cilantro is the one ingredient that lets you know that it's homemade. That's how I always can tell.
Absolutely. Because it can hide in a lot of things, but it really brings out this nice little flavor, makes that cilantro, makes that guacamole pop, which is perfect. So, and like we were talking about earlier, you can pair this with a lot of different things. Some things I like to pair it with include PJ's burritos. They're these nice USDA organic burritos. Small batch, nice ingredients, and they stay in the freezer. So you don't really have to put a lot of thought into them to cook them. Just take them out, put them in the microwave, and you're good to go. And even take some of this guacamole and spread it across the top of a burrito would be delicious.
Oh, that does sound good. Wow. So, you know, you could be doing something as simple as grabbing something out of the freezer, but you add this one little ingredient and all of a sudden there's a really fresh homemade kind of feel to meal. So sounds like it's time to really celebrate Guacamole Day.
It's the perfect time, right? And yeah, you're absolutely right. We did this whole recipe in the time of this segment. So you get yourself these few ingredients, you put that burrito in the microwave, and by the time it's done, you've got the guacamole to pair with.
Boom, it's a fiesta. Thank you so much. We appreciate you being with us on River City Live.
Absolutely. Thank you again for having me.
Ooh, that was good.